fascinating world of trivia, where even a right answer can catch you in a trap. On Trivia Trap! The juniors are ready, the seniors are set to play, and here's the host of Trivia Trap, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you, and a happy Friday morning to you. Welcome to Trivia Trap. We have two very excited teams ready to play our game. First of all, I want you to meet our seniors. They're all over the age of 30, and boy, are they excited, because they are returning champions. They won, what is it, a little over $28,000? Is that the figure? I think that was the figure. A little over $17,000. I'll try to give you some more money. Either way, we're doing just great. And hello, Lucille.
Oh, that's great. I'm Lucille Burnett, and I'm a housewife.
And a rich one, too. You're doing just
getting
fine.
Here.
George, you're back.
Hi, Bob. I'm George Castaldi, and I'm still a master technician.
Gail.
I'm Gail Greenberg, and I'm a graphic designer.
Welcome our seniors to our show. Returning champions. What fun we had yesterday, you guys, splitting that $10,000. George got a little excited, so stay away from me when you win the money, okay?
Yes, sir.
See, I only let pretty girls, you know, get close when you win.
I agree, Bob.
You understand?
I agree.
Let's meet the new juniors now. Brett, how are you?
Yay!
Hi, Bob. My name is Brett Hansard. I'm a freshman journalism student at Cal State Northridge.
Nice to have you here. I went to that college. Melody?
Hi, my name is Melody Nicholas, and I'm an L.A. County Lake and Pool lifeguard, and I'm also a nursing student and specializing in emergency medicine.
Well, you can save my life anytime you want to. Carrie?
I'm Carrie Lee. I'm an elementary school teacher working on a degree in speech pathology.
Welcome the juniors to our show. Good luck to our two teams. Let's begin our game right now, as we always do, with our seniors over here. Lucille, you just keep making the right decisions. You start off a little slow. I worry about you. Here's what's going to happen. I'm going to show you two rows of answers. Up on the top row, we see these. A U.S. citizen, photographed only clothed, a virgin, and a female. On the bottom are these. John Wayne, Errol Flynn, Charles Chaplin, and Clark Gable. What will it be, the top or the bottom?
The bottom.
I knew you would. I had it in my hand. Here's your question, seniors. During World War II, the Nazis offered a $5,000 reward for this actor so Hitler could put him in a cage like a gorilla. Who was he? You must eliminate the wrong answers in order to get to the right answer. If you can find all three wrong answers, your team gets $300. Lucille, began.
I'll cut Clark Gable.
You want to cut the answer, Clark Gable? Audience says, yeah. For our seniors, cut the answer, Clark Gable. Can you believe that?
I can't.
I couldn't believe it either. You're starting off like you always do, with nothing. I don't know how you do that. No,
oh, well.
It's true. World War II, the Nazis offered a $5,000 reward so that Hitler could put Clark Gable in a cage like a gorilla. Well, interesting bit of trivia. You didn't win any money with it, but you did learn something, didn't you, George?
We'll come back.
I knew you would.
We'll come back.
Okay, let's go right to our juniors. Brett, yeah. Now, you get to choose the answers. The U.S. citizen up on top and the other answers on the bottom. Juniors, take a look at these. Gopher wood, camphor wood, sandalwood, and ash. What will it be, top
take
or bottom?
Take the top.
Yeah.
You want the top. Juniors, your question. Miss America pageant chairman Albert Marks has just announced a pending rule change. From now on, future Miss America contestants must affirm that they have always been this. You must eliminate the wrong answers. All three of them, and you get $300. Brett?
I'll cut a virgin.
You want to cut the answer a virgin?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's do that. Cut that answer, please.
Yeah.
Yes. Melody, find another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut a U.S. citizen.
All right, sounds good to me. Can we eliminate the answer,
yeah.
U.S. citizen?
Yeah!
Carrie, two answers remain. Remember the question. Albert Marks, the pageant chairman, has just announced a pending rule change. From now on, the future Miss America contestants must affirm that they have always been this. Find the last wrong answer, and you get $300.
I'm going to cut a female.
Female.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh, well, come on. Yeah, come on. Come on. Yeah.
Come on. Cut the answer, a female.
That's all right.
Caught in our trivia trap. Can you believe they made that announcement? You know, the reason for this rule is that they want to make certain that no one who enters the pageant turns out to be a transsexual. Here he is, Miss Owner. You did eliminate two of them, though. You get $100, Juniors. No money for the seniors, but, you know, they always start slow. We'll pause with these words, and we'll be right back with more Trivia Tap in just a moment. Welcome back to Trivia Trap. Very quickly, our juniors have $100, and our seniors are starting off like they always do. Returning champions have nothing to this point, but look out, they do make it sometimes. Hey, the first team that gets to $1,000 wins the game has a chance to play for $10,000. So let's see if you can't get on the board now. George, Gail, and Lucille. And George, you pick the answers. Bottom row, gopher wood, camphor wood, sandalwood, and ash. On the top are these, George. Take a look. Goodrich, Burger King, the National Guard, and Avis. What will it be, top or bottom?
The top.
Going to the top. And here's your question. Whose advertising slogan is, "We're the other guys"? Find the wrong answers, George.
I will cut Avis.
We're the other guys. He'd like to cut the answer, Avis. Let's do that for the seniors.
Here we go, guys.
Gail.
Come on,
I'm going to cut the National Guard.
Atta girl.
You don't think that's their slogan, we're the other guys, huh?
No.
All right, cut the National Guard then.
Yeah.
Right on. Lucille, two answers remain. Whose advertising slogan is, we're the other guys? Find the last wrong answer.
I hope it's Goodrich.
You're cutting Goodrich? Take a look to your right and see deep despondency. Let's cut the answer, Goodrich, for $300.
That's all right.
Yeah.
We'll come back.
They're the ones that they don't have the blimp.
That's right.
So they're the other guys. Right. You got two of them, though, so we'll give you $100. You tied up the game, and that's the way you're supposed to do it.
Yeah.
All right, Melody, let's go right to the juniors and let them play the game. On the bottom, you've seen them. On the top are these. Now, Melody, Regal Beagle, Achilles, Super Jane, or Hercules? Top or bottom?
We'll take the top, Bob.
Go at the top. Did I say Regal Beagle? I meant Regal Eagle. Been watching too much television, haven't I? Yeah. That's where Jack Tripper goes, isn't there?
Right.
Boy, do I know a lot about nothing. Okay, juniors, what was Howard Hughes' giant aircraft called before it was nicknamed the Spruce Goose? Find the wrong answers for $300. Melody, begin.
I'm going to cut Super Jane.
Super Jane you'd like to cut? Okay, for our juniors, cut that answer, Super Jane. Good. Carrie, find another wrong answer.
I'm going to cut Hercules.
Hercules is the one. Listen.
Oh.
Oh, I know. But they're not always right up there.
Come on.
Most of the time, but not always. Okay, cut Hercules.
Oh.
That's what it was called, yeah. Before it was nicknamed the Spruce Goose, it was called Hercules. You got rid of one wrong answer, add another $50 to our juniors. So, there we have it. At the end of our round, juniors have $150. Seniors have $100. And we're going to pause for a couple of commercial words. We never did find out about gopher wood, camphor wood, sandalwood, and ash. It's a very interesting question. It's going to be kind of fun. We'll play with you at home. Here's the question. What does the Bible say Noah's Ark was made of? Gopher wood, camphor wood, sandalwood, or ash? I'll tell you the answer, and we'll play our $1,000 trivia race when we come back in just a moment. Trivia Trap, how did you do with our question? Very interesting trivia question, too. You can try this one out at a party. The question was, what does the Bible say Noah's Ark was made of? Correct answer, gopher wood, camphor wood, sandalwood, or ash? My mother's going to be very proud. I'm quoting from the Bible now. The book of Genesis, chapter 6, verse 14, it says, make thee an ark of gopher wood. That's the answer. Back to our game. Juniors, $150. Seniors, $100. The goal is to get to $1,000. And we do that by playing our $1,000 trivia race. So if you're ready, come with me and let's begin the race right now. Okay, we'll play our trivia race until one of our teams reaches $1,000. The winner then goes on to play for $10,000. And our juniors are out in front, barely, by $50, so that means they get to go first. And in the trivia race, every question is worth $100. But after the 10th question, the values then double. Now, each team will have three chances to come up with the correct answer. If all three of you miss, control will then go over to the other team. So, juniors, we'll start with you. And, Brett, you get to pick the first question. Nicknames, bounty, or dog?
I'll take nicknames, Bob.
Nicknames for $100. Remember, you have $150, and you're trying to get to $1,000. Here we go. What is Manfred von Richthofen better known as?
The Baron?
Enough. Is that enough, judges? He said the Baron. Not enough. Melody?
Baron von Hess. I don't know.
Oh, I'm sorry. Carrie?
The Red Baron.
It's the Red Baron. Sure. Saved your team again. Brett?
Dog.
Dog for $100. You have $250. Roy Rogers' horse was named Trigger. What was his dog's name? Melody?
Silver.
No. Carrie?
Blackie?
Don't know. Bullet. Frozen at $250. Here we go. Seniors, you have $100. Now, Lucille, pick a question.
Military.
Military for $100. Your question. In feudal Japan, what was the name given to the supreme military commander? George. Gail knows.
Shogun.
Shogun is right. Yes. $200. Again, Lucille, the question.
Old TV.
Old TV. For $100, what was the name of the fort in the TV series F Troop?
Apache?
No, incorrect. George.
Fort Lewis.
No, I'm sorry, Gail.
McKinley?
No, sorry again. Fort Courage.
F Troop.
Frozen at $200. Back we go to the juniors with $250. And Brett, you get to pick the question.
I'll take 50s rock.
50s rock. My kind of music. Tutti Frutti was the first hit for which rock and roll superstar of the 50s?
Little Richie.
That's it, Little Richie. $350. Melody, what will it be?
We're going to take Bounty.
Bounty for $100, juniors. After the mutiny on the Bounty, on what South Pacific island did Fletcher Christian land? Carrie? Save your team, Brett.
The Bahamas.
Pitcairn's Island. Also the title of the third book in the Bounty trilogy. You're frozen at $350. Back to the seniors. Lucille. With $200, Lucille, pick a question.
Names.
Names for $100, seniors. In Gulliver's Travels, what was the name of the people who were very, very tiny?
Lilliputton?
Close, but no banana, I don't think. George?
The Lilliputs.
No.
Lilliputs?
No.
Lilliputs.
No.
Give us a break.
That's it. Lilliputians. you're frozen at $200 and I'm paralyzed. Back to the juniors, Melody.
Okay, let's try Washington.
Washington. For $100, when President Reagan was shot, who said, as of now, I am in control here?
Haig.
Alexander Haig, yes. $150, all right. Carrie.
I'd like to take Bourne, please.
Bourne for $100. Here's the question, in what country was Anne Margaret born?
Sweden.
That's right, Sweden. $550 for the juniors. Brett, pick a question.
I'll take Hit Movie, please.
Hit Movie for $100. You have $550 trying to get to $1,000. What 1984 movie hit used the advertising line, they're here to save the world?
V.
No. Melody.
Carrie. Ghostbusters.
That's it, Ghostbusters. All right, that was our 10th question. Hereafter, every question is worth $200. Juniors have $650, seniors have $200. Brett, again, pick a question.
Watergate, please.
Watergate for $200. What famous book did Woodward and Bernstein write about the Watergate?
All the President's
That's
Men.
That's the correct answer, All the President's Men. $850. Melody.
Cartoon.
Cartoons for $200. Get it right. You become our champions and a chance to play for $10,000. This is for the game. What cartoonist created the comic strips Terry and the Pirates and Steve Cannon? Terry and the Pirates and Steve Cannon. Melody.
I don't know.
My fault. Go ahead, Melody.
Oh, okay. Dennis Menace.
Carrie, do you know?
No.
You don't know? Brett, save your team.
I don't know.
Don't know either? Milt Caniff. Milt Caniff is the answer we're looking for. You're frozen at $850. Okay, seniors. Lucille, you have $200 trying to get to $1,000. Which will it be?
Ghosts.
Ghosts. For $200, seniors, according to folklore, who is the ghost that haunts the seas off the Cape of Good Hope, South Africa? George.
Serious.
Gail.
Mr. Muir?
No. The Flying Dutchman. You're frozen at $200. Again, juniors, a chance to win this game. Melody?
Kung Fu.
Kung Fu for the game and a chance to play for $10,000 on the TV series Kung Fu. What nickname did Master Po call young Kane?
Little Grasshopper.
Grasshopper Enzyme! There they are, our champions. Now, you've had slow starts before, folks.
Awesome.
But never that slow. $200 today. But let me tell you, let's see. Lucille, you won a little over $7,000. George won a little over $7,000. As a team, you won over $17,000. I hope you've enjoyed our show. We really enjoyed having you here, Lucille. Best of luck. George, you're a really nice man. Thank you for playing the game. Gail, the very best of luck to you. We'll see you again.
Thank you.
Whoa, what? Champions of the juniors, they'll be back to play for $10,000 right after this. What's up? We have new champions. Let's bring them in right now, our juniors. Congratulations, Melody, Carrie, and Brett. Very good indeed. You won the game now. You want to play for the big money? There's $10,000 waiting for you. I hope you win it. Go right over there and get in position. Let's play the game. Now, you did a great job playing as partners. Up until now, you've played as partners, but now you're on your own trying to win some money for yourselves. And your positions have been determined by your success in the trivia race. And, Carrie, you're there in the number one slot. That means that you have the first option to play or pass on the first group of answers as we begin our climb up our trivia ladder toward that pot of gold of $10,000. So let's go. Right to the first level. And, Carrie, take a look at these answers and tell me if you want to play or pass. Gimbel Brothers, Brigham Young, Andrew Johnson, J.C. Penney.
I'd like to pass.
I'm going to pass those on to Brett. Brett, in the number two slot, you can do the same. You can play or you can pass them on to Melody.
I think I'll pass also.
Melody, they're yours.
I'll play.
Okay, because I don't want it. Melody, the question's worth $1,000. If you get it right, you win the $1,000 and then have a chance to play for $10,000. And here's your question. Who started the nation's first department store? Is the correct answer Gimbel Brothers, Brigham Young, Andrew Johnson, or J.C. Penney?
I'm going to say J.C. Penney.
J.C. Penney, you say? Good luck, and let's see. For $1,000, a chance to play for $10. Is it J.C. Penney? Brigham Young is the correct answer. Melody, we have to say goodbye to you. We'll
okay.
see you, though, when you come back to defend your crown with your team. See you on Monday. All right, Carrie and Brett, here we go. To the next level of our ladder, and let's see what you think about these answers. Elizabeth Taylor, Dolly Parton, Lady Bird Johnson, Mata Hari. Again, Carrie, you can play or you can pass.
I'd like to play.
Well, play for $1,000 and a chance to play for $10,000. Which of these women was born Claudia Alta Taylor? I need the correct answer. Claudia Alta Taylor.
I'll say Elizabeth Taylor.
Elizabeth Taylor. Interesting choice. Let's see. $4,000 and a chance to go right up to the top of our trivia ladder where there's $10,000. Good luck, Carrie. Is it Elizabeth Taylor? No, I'm sorry. Lady Bird Johnson. She was born Claudia Alta Taylor. Carrie, we have to say goodbye to you. Have yourself a nice weekend. You'll be back on Monday, though, with your team to defend your trivia crown. Bye-bye, Carrie. All right, big guy, this is it. Chance to win 10 grand. All you have to do is give me the answer to the next group of answers. If you're ready, Brett, let's go up to that next level. Lawrence Welk, Jack Klugman, Cary Grant, Jack Nicholson. Those are the answers. Here's your question. Which of these famous personalities wears a toupee? Is the correct answer Lawrence Welk, Jack Klugman, Cary Grant, or Jack Nicholson?
I'll guess Lawrence Welk.
Lawrence Welk, you guess. I don't know. The audience says, This is for a chance to play for $10,000. I want you to get this one right. How about it? Does Lawrence Welk wear a toupee? He does not. Jack Klugman. Klugman wears the toupee. Hey, you don't get the $1,000. You don't get a chance to play for the $10,000. But as you know, we'll see you back here on Monday. We'll pause for these words, and we'll be right back with more Trivia Chat in just a moment from now. Top today, but there's $10,000 waiting for you on Monday. You know, you get to come back 5 times if you are a champion. Didn't do too bad today, unseated a pretty good team. Those seniors were really on their way. So, Carrie and Brett And Melody, we want you to have a very nice weekend. And we want you to have a nice weekend, too. Until Monday, please drive carefully. And please join us Monday morning. I'm Bob Eubanks for all the gang here on Trivia Trap, saying so long for now. We'll see you Monday morning. Bye-bye.
Hi, Dad.
Hi.
I don't really need your help, but I just wanted to let you know that I'm going to win $1 million. Because the U.S. president appeared on Laugh-In as Richard Nixon, that's my final answer.
He's won $1 million!